Mexico has been named one of the most attractive countries in Latin America by foreign investors. Mexico's free trade agreement with Europe will be approved in a matter of weeks. And the Attorney General has presented three requests to extradite Chihuahua's fugitive ex-governor, Cesar Duarte. Hello and welcome to today's edition of Mexico News Network's Breaking News Business. I'm your host, Joseph Garza. Let's get down to the information. 6 out of 10 investors from North America, Europe, and Asia would choose Mexico as a destination for their investments and the elimination of taxes thanks to their trade agreements with other countries, a study by Baker McKenzie reveals. The survey revealed that 61% of investors see Mexico as the best destination for acquisitions, only behind Chile, 72%, and Brazil, 66%. Since 2012, the United States, Belgium, and Israel have been the main foreign investors in Mexico for transaction values. Consumer goods, energy, and telecommunications have been the most specific industries, the study explains. Among the positive points that investors see in Mexico are the facts that it is the second largest economy in Latin America. It's open to foreign direct investment, has good infrastructure, reforms in telecommunications and energy, and, of course, its proximity to the United States. Among the cons are uncertainty regarding NAFTA, lower economic growth, security problems related to the violence of criminal groups, corruption, and a 57% informality rate. Moving on from this story, the modernization of the free trade agreement between the European Union and Mexico is now just a few weeks away from being ratified, whereas an updated NAFTA has made minimal progress and is in danger of disappearing. At the end of the 8th round of negotiations and 7 months after beginning the process, the negotiation teams of the Europe-Mexico Free Trade Agreement have reached accords on key issues, such as access to markets, rules of origin, technical barriers to trade, and intellectual property. In contrast, the North American Free Trade Agreement has only managed to close 2 chapters, none of the controversial ones, in almost 5 months and 6 rounds of negotiations. For Mexico, an agreement with the European Union is now viewed as essential as part of its strategy to reduce trade dependency with the United States, due to Trump's threats to withdraw his country from NAFTA. Mexico's trade agreement with the European Union covers industrial products, agricultural goods, official purchases, and investments. In other news, on Friday, the Federal Attorney General's office presented 3 formal requests for the extradition of the former governor of Chihuahua, Cesar Duarte, 2 of which correspond to the General Prosecutor's Office of the State of Chihuahua, and another corresponds to the Federal Attorney General. It is also working on 8 requests to follow up on the 11 criminal cases that were filed. The person in charge of the office of the PGR, Alberto Elias Beltran, explained that the corresponding procedures are already being carried out with foreign authorities in order to initiate the extradition proceedings. Due to Duarte's presumption of innocence, the identity of the nation to which these 3 extradition requests were issued cannot be given at this time. The Federal Attorney General is working hand-in-hand with the State Attorney General of Chihuahua and is informed of each of the procedures that are carried out, Beltran said. He insisted that they are not working with political overtones or under pressure of any kind. And finally, let's turn to the markets. The Mexican peso increased 0.0233 or 0.13% to 18.6293 from 18.6060 in the previous trading session. IPC Mexico decreased 216 points, or 0.43%, to 49,696 from 49,912 in the previous trading session. This was all for today. Thank you for staying with us. I'm Joseph Garza. Remember to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. Log on to MexicoNewsNetwork.com for more information on Mexico and the world. Until next time.